I really see stewardship as another development such as that, which is the response to what's going on in the world today. And I see it as something that's kind of all-embracing. It ties everything together in living out the Christian life. Theology of the body really is stewardship of the body. You remember about 3 years ago, we had the week of study days on stewardship. Father Andrew Kemberling came from Denver. And I was so pleased he mentioned that as an example, because it's something that I have been pondering myself, that stewardship of the body. God, the body is kind of a material gift of God to us. The body is the tabernacle of our person, and we're meant to use it in order to live out our vocation, not just married couples, but all of it. This is how we enter into relationship with each other. So to use it for God's purposes. We're also living in a world nowadays, and I think in addition to family breakdown, we have this to deal with. People are getting more and more isolated. God didn't create us to be an autonomous being. That's a misnomer. He created us for communion. We know communion with God. We become capable of communion with God by communion with one another. And I notice the effects because I live next door to a high school, you know? So I'm walking back and forth, and I see the kids and the adults walking back and forth. The adults, you know, they'll catch my eye, smile, and we'll nod to each other and say hello. The kids are completely oblivious. No acknowledgement of my existence. And it's not just this school, because I've experienced this elsewhere as well when I'm away from here. So it's kind of what's it's got getting into this narcissistic, increasingly isolated culture. So Dave said it so well that stewardship means being God-centered, being other-centered. And that's the way God created us to be. That's how we're going to find happiness. And living this spirituality of stewardship is what will get us there. Again, it's deep within our tradition. We think about stewardship of our body, stewardship of the environment, the ecological environment, the social environment, as Pope Francis has spoken of, also needs stewardship. We see that at the very beginning. God created them male and female, and he gave them dominion over the earth. So, stewardship of our bodies and of the environment in the sense of all of the material creation. And there's also stewardship of the spiritual gifts as well. The faith, the truths of the faith that we are called, especially as ordained ministers, to hand on. The liturgy is a gift God gives us. It's not something of our own creation or remaking. So all of these gifts, to understand that God gave us, to use them, to give back with an increase, with generosity. So I was mentioning, Dave, also you may have heard me mention before, so they've been at it for 20 years, and about a third of the parishes are solid stewardship parishes. They don't have their people yet within that 4-7% range. This is a multi-generational effort. We can't think that we're gonna see the success of stewardship in our archdiocese, maybe not even in our lifetimes. So I see you all, thank you so much for your interest and your work in promoting it in your parishes. The idea is to do it in a more kind of systematic, intentional way all throughout the archdiocese. But I see us here in this room and others who couldn't be here as kind of like the construction workers in the Middle Ages, you know, who built those glorious cathedrals. They knew they wouldn't see the cathedral completed in their age. But they did it because they didn't do it for themselves or to show off. They did it for the glory of God. And they knew it was going to take many generations, some took many centuries. So I think that's, we're beginning the work of building a beautiful cathedral for God in inculcating this spirituality in our people here that has such tremendous power for transforming the culture with the values of the gospel, which we know is very much needed here. So thank you for your commitment to that. Let's remember that we're doing this for the glory of God. It is ultimately God's work. Let us ask him for the grace to do it out there.
Amen.